Good morning, guys. I don't see anyone. Come on. Join us here with the camera, open camera, please. Whoever feels comfortable, of course.
Hi, Jessica. Hi, Daliane.
Jessica, Daliane, Demaurer, Marcinha, and Priscila. Welcome, guys. Oh, there was Thiago was here. I think
yes.
He's not anymore. Oh. Ah, Thiago's back. Hello, Thiago. Good morning. So hi. First thing, hi, Marcinha. Is someone here for the first time? Maybe Thiago? Yes, Thiago, can you raise your hand. I think there's an option. Or in the chat, let me see if he wrote something. Well, Thiago, if you can hear us, I will just quickly explain a little bit about ACDC. ACDC stands for Academy of Creativity, and it was created by students of Reaprendizagem Criativa, of Murilo Gun. They started getting together a few years ago because they felt the need to talk about the course, because you start questioning a lot of things, you learn a lot of things about creativity and innovation, and you just feel like talking to other people that are on the same energy. And with the quarantine, we started gathering online, and it's been more than 100 days that we are doing this every day now. There are meetings every day. And we also started with the English experience, I think 1 or 2 months ago. So welcome. And we are going to start with our check-in. So, Paulinha, the floor is yours.
Thanks, girl. 1 second. Just let me share here. Morning, everybody. Welcome. I think we have two Thiagos here. Maybe they're new. Welcome. And we're going to talk about, it's a series of, it's a series that we're doing to talk about the five intelligence that are I think it's our future skills, no? But it's not the future, it's present. But before that, I think it's going to be very good if we answer this question before we start this conversation, because I think we know what it is, but maybe we don't stop to think really, what is technology for me? What is technologies nowadays? Okay, so Camila, do you think we're going to breakout rooms?
No, I think we can do it here.
Can do it here?
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
I think we can do it in the chat here, okay? We have 2 minutes. You think, what is technology for me? What I think is technology for me? What kind of technologies we're dealing today? And when you don't press enter, when it's okay, you just say, okay, and we press enter together. 3, 2, 1, go.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. Welcome, Thiago.
Sorry.
No, no problem.
No problem. If you want to say something, just put unmute on your microphone. No problem, okay?
The two Thiagos is I'm.
Okay.
Medeiros and Damas.
And Damas.
Okay, it's an hologram. Can you read to us, Camilo?
Yes. So I put technology helps us to have more time for nicer things. Paulinha, technology is everything that helps us in our daily life and connect us with other people. Daliane, for me, technology, it's a way to solve a lot of problems, but nowadays it's like air. People cannot live without it. Pri, it's like emotions, something that you cannot see, but it's all around. Nice. Victory, techniques that bring innovation. André, a tool. Jessica, it's an opportunity to be closer to other people, to have access to knowledge and places. And Marcinha, it is a new and interesting tool. Nice.
Okay, that's nice, girls.
Interesting.
Before we start, I think Thiago is new here too. We're going to say very quickly about what makes the trigger for us to understand what is the what we talk about, skills of the future, okay? In a number search, Oxford University find out that 47% of professions would be automated in next 20 years. This research is from 2013, okay? It's 7 years already. So we have 13 years ahead that 47% we're going to disappear. And what makes us, what can we do to not let that happen? The great differential of the human is to be a human being, okay? The first one is what we know at that call center, phone calls that girls and boys that automatically are the first one to be substituted. And what can they do in their jobs that make them special? Just being human, okay? What we have to think, or all these skills or intelligences depends on we being human, okay? Before that, we have four problems that we have to understand. First, we have to accept that we have to change. So if you don't accept that you have to change, nothing is gonna happen. Second one, we have to confirm that I won't understand everything. That what causes anxiety in everybody, because I have to understand everything that's going on. No, you won't understand what's going on. Third problem, know that skill, what exactly the skills that I have to develop, what I don't have and I have to develop. The great thing here at everything we're going to talk about, we can learn, okay? I didn't born with empathy, I didn't born with, everything we can learn. And the fourth problem is not enough to know, we have to do it, okay? We know a lot of people that say a lot of things, I have to do that, I will do that, and do nothing, okay? Remember, Darwin already said that the world is not for the stronger. The world is made for the more adaptable. So we can adapt. Everybody can be adaptable to that situation, okay? And this is what we're going to talk about today. The first one, we already talked, intrapersonal intelligence. The second one, interpersonal intelligence. We skipped creative intelligence. That's going to be our last talk because it's the most heavy, and I think we have to have a meeting, a longer meeting, okay? We're gonna talk about today inter-artificial intelligence, okay? But what the hell is that? Remember, this GIF is very funny because it's the angry that we have a lot of times. I hate technology. I don't wanna deal with that. And that was a meme that was very famous at the time. And we have to understand, if we need to learn to deal with people, it's interpersonal, okay? We have to do with people. But now we're talking about we need to learn to the machines. We need to learn to deal with the machines. And machines, everything. When I say not only physical machines, okay? But something connected to technology. We have to learn that. But remember, you won't learn everything. You have to choose what you really want or what do you think it make sense to you to learn, okay? So here it is. WhatsApp, it's one technology. Do you agree with that? And a lot of times we see people that the WhatsApp kidnap our attention. Look the pressure we have here. You know that I send a message and I want an answer immediately. Isn't that everybody? How many of us in this time, in this quarantine time, we do like that all the time? Okay? We have to learn to deal with that. Okay? The anxiety of everybody, I send a message, I want to answer immediately. We don't have to do that. Say, Camila.
Can I say something?
Yes.
Someone sent a text about WhatsApp, about this that you're talking about in the group, like a few weeks ago. Okay. And then I started noticing that let's say that I sent a message to someone. I noticed that at least in that day, three or four people, they said the same thing for me when they answered, because they answered like 1 hour later. And they all said, oh, I'm so sorry I didn't reply sooner. Because we have this idea now that we need to be available like 24 hours a day, and that's insane. And then I try to say, no, you don't need to say I'm sorry. I sent the message and you can take your time. I mean, you don't need to reply immediately. But it's crazy because we put ourselves in this situation. I also say, oh, I'm sorry I didn't reply, but man, we are not obligated to be there like all the time. It's crazy. It's really, really crazy.
I think we are all in this situation. And we really suffer when, oh, sorry, I was taking a bath. Okay, it's not a problem, okay? And that is what I want for us to understand. We make our time. And when we put ourselves in that situation, we are under a lot of pressure that makes us feel uncomfortable, okay? I'm just saying that you have to think in your life what makes you uncomfortable. But it's not okay to be kidnapped by the WhatsApp, to be kidnapped by the social media. Do you agree with me? How many times I don't know, it's not a lost time, okay? But we spend in the social media like that. Oh, Instagram. It's making us crazy. How many of us know someone, not us, but someone that maybe had a little problem with social medias? Isn't that? We love to stalk. Is that stalkier? Is that in English? Stalkier. Okay. I put something in how many people like it, compartilhou, share it, and do the thing. When we put in story, we see like this all the time. Oh, who saw my story? Okay, the message is done. We do that without knowing. It's our subconscious, okay? We don't realize that, but we do that all the time. And that Curtida from the... Say, Victoria, please help me.
Let me just make a compliment about what you were saying, because that's why I think it's interesting to understand technology from behind, let's say. Because if you understand how the algorithm is built, or how the tools are made, and which technology they use to catch our attention, then you start figuring out that your behavior when using it, you can decide if you let the technology control you, or you understand how it's made, and then you control it. So that's why I think it's interesting having this inter-artificial intelligence is also knowing how it's made, and then I can decide if I let the technology do that to me or no, you know?
If we want to philosophy about that, it's almost like my ego, isn't that? Who's gonna control? Your ego is gonna control you, or you will control your ego? But to control my ego, I have to understand him. This is the same thing in inter-artificial intelligence. We have to understand how things work. We have to minimal understand and accept, okay. And we don't realize, I make a challenge to you. How many, pay attention, how many times you pass in the social medias and how many times you did that. Oh, who is this girl? You go to all the way down and who is his friend of who? Harris, what that bitch that put a curtida on you? I don't know how to use curtida. English girls?
Like.
Thank you. How many likes do we have? Okay. And I think it's very interesting to understand that a long time ago, it been discussed the Internet of Things, okay? And the solutions that can be, that can happen with that. It's an incredible, incredible technology. And we can imagine partners like Brastemp and Pão de Açúcar, isn't that? My refrigerator have a list of what I want to shop and it sends a message to Pão de Açúcar and that, you know, something that we have to understand that the technology, what I want to say, technology is already there. We don't know that, but it is already there, okay? Like healthcare applicatives that controls diabetes immediately, okay? My boss had a, I think his daughter have diabetes and he has a chip on her and he control the level of diabetes in the Japan, okay? No problem. Wherever he is, he controls her diabetes. It's incredible, okay? And it's available, okay? So beware of social networks. They hijack our lives. I know a lot of people that live for that. And that's what we call, that was what we call Instagram life, okay? It's not the real life. It's just Instagram life because everybody's happy there. Do you really think we can be happy every day? No, I don't think so. And it's okay, okay? So, to make an example, what is available, and it's very available, I want you to watch this Apple Watch advertising, okay? It's 1 minute and a half, and I think we're gonna like it. Okay, let's try it here. You just say if you can hear that.
Time. And takes phone calls. This watch tells time and turns on lights and opens up doors. This watch tells time and communicates with satellites 12,427 miles above the Earth. It wakes you up and gets you onto subways and plays every Elton John studio album.
Hey Siri, play Tumbleweed Connection.
Ever recorded.
Play Goodbye Yellow Brick Road.
Play Mad Men Across the Water.
This watch tells time and sets timers and sets your pace and warns you when it's too loud and texts your friends and opens the portals. Kidding. And tracks your distance underwater and starts competitions and accepts challenges and tracks your workouts and tells you which direction you should be going and reminds you to breathe and has an app that measures the exact timing of the electrical waves traveling through the upper and lower chambers of your heart, otherwise known as an electrocardiogram. So in conclusion, just to reiterate, this watch tells time, among other things.
See, this watch even tells what time is it. I know a lot of people that have Apple Watch and don't use like three things. The discussion here, Rip, look what I want you to understand. We're talking about technology, we're talking about new things, but we're talking about human beings, okay? Let me just put this to you to understand. Apple Watch, learner curve, technology already exists. Again, we bump on human beings. And when we go and we look to the human beings, that's why this technology, like Apple Watch, was born. Remember when I said about make a mantra, that companies make mantras? That's how Apple works. And this next advertising is just to show you what is a technology that connects people. We're talking about people connection, not technology. We're talking about taking care of people, okay? Let me try this here.
Dear Mr. Cook.
Dear Apple.
Dear Tim.
To tcook at apple.com.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi.
Hey, good morning.
Nice to meet you. Okay, hello.
So, the run began as usual.
I was 32 weeks pregnant, getting ready to go to bed.
The next morning, I'd have notifications on my watch and my phone saying,
your heart rate is elevated. And I was like, huh.
That's strange.
And I run my EKG, and it says 220 beats. And I'm like, something's not right. I told my husband, like, we need to go. He was like, well, I'm in the middle of cutting grass. I'm like, we need to go.
And then suddenly, I woke up to EMTs.
Oh, this is my husband, Kyle. He's going out to cut the grass.
When I fell, it automatically called 911, and then it calls my wife. When I think about what happened and what could have happened.
Once we got to the hospital, they realized it was some sort of infection. My heart rate was spiking, and it was causing the baby's heart rate to get lower and lower. So, emergency C-section, and she was born.
Had I not had surgery, it estimated that I would have had a heart attack within less than 12 months.
I mean, like, I'm like, I have goosebumps. I don't know if you can see them through, like, the camera. It's crazy.
It's not something you think of, your watch.
Ugh.
Saving your life.
Can you wave hi?
In the past, I didn't prioritize taking care of myself.
Yeah, so these are probably one of the largest pairs of pants I have. I'm standing in one of the legs of them.
But now I've gained the ability to be active in ways that I never would have dreamed of. All because the computer on my wrist told me it was time to fill the rings.
Yeah, closing rings. It's like this little reminder going, okay, you could do a little better today.
When I see the little rings of like, get your moves in today, sometimes I used to be like, mind your business, Apple Watch. But then it's like, you know what? I do need to get my move in.
I like the idea of achievements that you get for every small things done.
It has, I just reminded me I should stand up, by the way.
I'm the blur.
He's the blur. Yeah, that's his nickname, is the blur. Harrison is on the autism spectrum, and he's on the cross country and track teams here at the school. He was having some issues with anxiety and crowd noise.
The sound of the cheering just
throws me off.
So I paired up my watch with my headphones, and the music helps me focus.
When he started running with music playing, it was like seeing a different athlete. This moment of triumph, goosebumps, and tears, and it was cinematic.
Apple needs to know this happened. What you did in your brainstorming sessions came to life and helped save mine.
Dear Tim.
Dear Apple.
Dear Mr. Cook.
I just had to tell my story. I will be forever grateful.
I had no idea that one day it would save my life.
What I want to say is thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See that? Can't we understand how a company makes a product that is the people that matters? I think maybe one or two or three of you saw my design thinking talking, and that's exactly what happens in Apple. They look to people, okay? So We have to understand that we have to burn the bridge. What is burn the bridge?
Do you know what's Paulinha frozen for you too?
It's frozen?
Yeah, it's frozen here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Maybe it's my internet. Are you listening? I'm going to stop sharing. Hi. Can you see me?
Oh, she's back. Yes, you're back.
Okay.
Well, just make a point. It's interesting to observe which technology is behind all these tools. So when Paulinha mentioned Apple Watch is one tool thinking about Internet of Things. If you think that we put internet in the watch, you have like this wide possibilities. And also the smartphones, we have a lot of sensors. Internet of Things is basically when we put sensor in things to make them intelligent. So in our smartphones, we have a lot of sensors that we don't even think about it daily. So we have geolocation, we have the sensor that can know if I'm doing this or that. That's why we have many games that can feel this. We have the sensors to know the speed. So when we walk or when we shake, our cell phones know it. We have the, you know, many sensors that together make all these possibilities possible. And it's the same thing with the smartwatch that can feel the heart and stuff like that. It's all sensors. But when we think that we can put these sensors in basically anything we think about it, then we can start thinking the power of technology. When Camila mentioned the freezer, but we can do it for plants to know if they have enough water or not. We can do it with, you know, anything. If you think about, if there is a sensor in there that can tell me the temperature, the speed, the humidity, you can think, you know, a lot of things. So that's what I would like to make a point to, for us to observe why these things do the things they do. You know, why, what is behind this all technology and how we relate ourselves to this artificial intelligence.
And we have to be very careful because, again, it's not to cause anxiety. Oh, I have to understand everything. No. But we have to be intelligent enough to see that these things, they are changing. And we have to adapt our lives to that. And it can be great when we know that. Burn the bridge. You know what's burn the bridge? Pass the bridge and burn it up. Because you don't have to how to come back, okay? Burn the bridge. Again, it depends on us. It's our attitude. We are always waiting for others to teach us. No. Oh, I have this technology, but I don't know. I don't understand how it works. Go to YouTube, okay? You don't have to wait for other people. Go and search what is your what you think is important for you, okay? Because, again, we are our greatest opponent, always. When we understand that it's not the world's fault, it's not fault anybody's fault, it only depends of us, what we want to do with that, okay? So now, do you want to say something else, Camila, Vitória, or we can go to breakout rooms? No, it's okay? And now, I invite you to go to our breakout rooms, and we'll have like 10 minutes that I want you to think now what I don't know and I want to learn about these technologies. What I don't know and what I want to learn, okay? I'm going to give you 10 minutes, like your breakout rooms.
And I think we saw all these nice videos and you talked about a lot of interesting things. So also, if you feel like talking about how technology is in your life, works in your life, and how it affects you, I think it's yes. Also something nice that can come up in the discussions.
Can be a discussion about that, okay? I think we're going to do three rooms. J, Just accept the invitation, okay?
Put your card on the shelf and just go there to the YMCA. I'm sure they can help you today.
Ha! Welcome back, YMCA. Okay, now the silent talks, and you can feel comfortable if you want to say what happened there.
I can't start because I need to get out earlier today for my job. So I talked with Priscilla. It's the first time that we talked together. It's great for me. I like the last meeting, I like to know other people. It's very excited. And I talked with her many things. We talked a lot. And we shared many experiences too. But about the question, I said to her that I like to search possibilities in technologies for my classes. I am an English teacher, so I like to create different kinds of possibilities to engage the students for their learning more, or they like the classes. So I love these apps and all of tools for education. And also, I create a profile in the Instagram for sharing these ideas with other teachers, not only English teachers, but all of the teachers, because many of my colleagues are asking me, oh, what can I do a video, or what can I bring for the students some games. So I am sharing these possibilities with other teachers in a collaborative network because I have some ideas, and the creativity, it's very important in this moment, and they answer, they contribute in their possibilities too, and I share these possibilities that they thinking about.
You know, that I think what is the beautiful thing in being a teacher, that we understand that the knowledge is the one thing that we share, and it raises on us. It doesn't make us smaller, it makes us bigger.
Mm-hmm. Deia, can you put your Instagram, this Instagram where you shared education things, on the chat?
Yeah, I will put. The name is Professor Autor, because I believe that the teacher is the author of their possibilities using the digital technologies. So they couldn't copy something in the internet. They could create their own materials. So they put their context, their realities in these materials. They could create videos, activities, games, and other things according to their reality. Because the internet have many possibilities, but when we create, it's more next to with our students, because we know their realities, their real needs.
Thanks.
And I am very happy with these discoveries with all the teachers. I am very happy. It's a good experience. But I agree with Priscilla too. The technology, it isn't all of the things. We could have other experience too. So the technology is one possibility, and it is not the most important thing. It's a way. It's a way. It's in the middle, not in the finish.
The end. Okay.
Nice. Thank you, Deia.
The end. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, I really enjoyed talking to Daya because we exchanged a lot of ideas. And it was really nice. And I was telling her that internet, of course, and the technologies, of course, is very important. But I like the idea of doing things without the technology sometimes. For example, when we were a child, we used to play on the streets, right? And it was so fun to be around our friends and don't use any tool, like just being there. And I see that the generation, the today's generation is always around the internet. And for example, if there is a big shutdown and you don't have access to anything, what are you gonna do, right? So we can play the things that you used to do in the past, but they could be very lost because they don't have the internet. So I was talking to her that I'm always criticizing a little bit. I think the criticizing is a little bit important in this, like we said before, because internet is great, but sometimes we can be controlled by that. And you have to be aware of it, right? So that's it.
Thanks, Priscilla. Did you realize, I think yesterday, WhatsApp had a little problem about 5 minutes in the day. Did you get that? Everybody was crazy. They called me. Your WhatsApp is a problem? Oh, it's my internet. No, 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 it's WhatsApp. Stop it 5 minutes. But the word went crazy. Oh, it's very... It's crazy. Hi, Murilo.
Murilo, can you hear us?
He's connected.
I think we'll ask him to share his view on technology. Can we do that?
Yes. You want to mention what we comment, Jessica, in the room?
Yeah, sure. I'm more introspective today, more listening. But yeah, it was interesting, the exchange we had, me, Vitória and Márcia, because we had different views of things, which is also very nice. So it took us around 5 minutes, like we exposed our ideas and then we like, okay, let's see how we can talk about it together. So it was nice. And so Marcia doesn't have a cell phone and she's here, I don't know how. And it's actually amazing how it's possible to connect. You just allow yourself to connect without using all these tools we have and oh my God, being super connected. So it was nice, it was a good insight. Because sometimes you think, oh, I have to connect even more to be able to talk to more people, to know different people, but actually sometimes if you disconnect, you get to like people who are more interesting maybe, who have more things to share, rather than just like be online all the time. So it was very, very nice, the talk.
Thanks, Jessica. I think we're passing through a time that we want to go back to ourselves and our origins and the simple things, but we can't forget that the technology is there and we can use it. But I think it's very like gamification. The teachers use that, maybe use that. The gamification you can do with paper. It's the concept that's important. It's not always about apps and technology. It's about concepts, okay? Marcia?
Yeah. My antenna is very good, and I develop it. I think we are giving much power to the cell phone, and I choose everything I want, everywhere I want to take part. I take part in about 5 webinars a day, at least, and meet many interesting people because I like to exchange ideas. I don't like to be the, I like to see faces, to see eyes, to see expressions in many people. And I want to look at the rainbow without the need of taking a photograph of me and sending this. I want to live. So that's it. And I don't need it. I don't need it. And some people tried, in other academies, tried to be a day or two without looking at a cell phone to feel how, inspired by me, they decided to try, inspired by me to try how to they would feel like that. And when I have a project, I developing projects now, I will have, but I select the people I'll give my number. That's it. It's by choice. I have a 92 years old mother. Everybody says I need a cell phone. I take care of her. It's only me and she, and I work, and it's very, I don't need it. I had a cell phone. I was robbed, and I was happy. That's it. And I'm here, and happier than I'm happier. I find out by simpler. I'm my simpler.
Marcia just reminds me about shows, because when we look around, everyone is recording the show just for choosing one video and post it, and never looks all the records they do during the show, and people stopped to pay attention present, you know, and live what is going on at the moment. So we have this side of this dark side of technology, because take our attention off the moment we are living.
I say that I'm out of the box. I'm only in the box like this. I'm really out of the box. And I love technology, but I want to use it for me, when I need. Everybody must have a car? No. Why technology? They are trying to convince us this, and everybody goes, almost everybody, not me.
Okay. Anybody else, or we can do our checkout? V?
Just one thing to conclude, what I mentioned in our room, it's all related to what Dai said, what Marcia said, is that for me, I believe the problem is not technology, but humans. I believe that the problem is in the values and the way we deal with things. And because technology for me is just a way to expand our possibilities. So the problem is not the technology as it is. The problem is how we use it. So that's what I believe. I don't see technology with bad eyes, but human with these, you know, characteristics to use technology in a bad way, then it's evidence, you know, how our values can be, you know, bad.
Daya, can you wait for just a picture? Let's do our picture. André, can you show yourself to our picture? Yes, handsome boy. 3, 2, 1, now. Let me see if it's okay.
I think it's... Would you like to have the hair of Camila?
Yes, her hair is great. Let me see here. Oh, it's a good picture. Thank you. Bye, Daya.
Bye-bye. I hope to see you soon. I love you so much.
I think
thank you, Daya. Have a good day.
It's my great routine being here with you all. Thank you. Thank you so much. See you the next time.
Bye-bye. I love this meeting.
Me too.
It's one of the best. Okay. The best ones, for sure. Always surprising us.
Nice.
Doing what Vittoria was saying, that all in our lives is balance, isn't that? That's our, I think it's our forever search for the balance. Not 80, not 8, 4, 40. Okay? I think that's what we have to search in our lives, I think. Anybody else? Camila, do you want to finish?
Yeah, I think we can go to our checkouts. But before that, is there anything that you want to share with us before? Like a final message?
Like a final message?
Otherwise?
No, for me.
Oh, I just wanted to say, it's, as I said to the girls in the group, it's such a important topic, this one, how we connect to the technology. And then it seems like it's always a discussion over like bad and good side, but actually it's like, it's part of our lives. You have to accept it. I think it's important for me. For example, I have diabetes, that you said the example before, and the technology helps me to control it. So I cannot I have to be grateful for it, actually, mm-hmm. and not like judge it or anything like that. So it's important that we discuss how to connect in a healthy way, like this interartificial. Yes, this is the topic. So, but I think it's like 1 hour is completely not enough to talk about it, because we have so many sides of it, and it's difficult to really get a conclusion for it in such a small time.
Yeah, I see our meetings like a provocation to what we have to think. It's more like that we don't end the talking. We don't have to only see one way of everything that we're talking here. And technology and interpersonal, artificial intelligence is really very a great discussion, because everybody have a different look to that. And I think that's what makes incredible.
There's one more thing that I discussed with Daya that I forgot to mention, is that when we talk about technology, it's not only the internet, right? Everything is technology. For example, our refrigerator is a technology, and this helps us, because in the past, people usually put the food on the fat of animals to how can I say,
preserve.
Yes, and nowadays something so common in our houses that we don't manage, imagine that it's a technology. So it's really great, right? And it's really great to discuss it, and to in order to us to use that to help us in our jobs, for example, or in other things. Sometimes people are suffering with something that the technology has the answer, right? So it's really great when we can discuss this. Thank you for the opportunity.
I think we could spend the rest of this year talking about that, but we don't have that.
Oh, thank you, Paulinha. Thank you, guys. So we can go to the checkout. We'll do it on the chat. Yes. So you can write, how are you feeling right now? How are you leaving the meeting, with one word or one sentence? And then you don't press enter. We press enter all together, okay? So when you finish writing, you just raise your hand so we know you are done. I'm here dancing already, because I know that Paulinha DJ will put some nice music in about a minute. So everyone is ready? Yes? Okay. So 1, 2, 3, go. So let's see. I'm very excited and very happy, because this meeting was amazing. Priscila, excited to learn more. Vitória, instigated. Daliane, always good to share with you guys. Every meeting we learn a lot. Marcinha, waiting more and more a new edition. Paulinha, happy and connected. And Jessica, thoughtful. Yeah, this was very interesting. Oh. Thoughtful. Jessica, what thoughtful means?
Iniciativa. Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Paulinha, thank you so much. It was very, very nice. Very interesting.
Thank you.
So, guys, we have another meeting on Saturday. We'll send on the group, and Marcinha will send you by email. So hope to see you there, and also next week. Ah, maybe we could, next week we'll have a meeting on a different time, so more people maybe can join. Like it's in a night time, like 7 p.m. But we'll send more details. Maybe for you it's better in the morning, but for some people it's nice to have the opportunity to come during the night. Okay? So you can open your microphones and say goodbye.
The advertising that I in Portuguese to understand better. I have that with
subtitles.
Subtitles.
Okay. Subtitles.
Okay. Thank you guys so much. See you. Now we can do the dance.
And I'll show you will find many ways to have a good time. Fun is staying in the
quiet.
Fun is staying in the quiet. They have everything for you to
live in the house in the
make real.